Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
We welcome all parishioners and visitors as we prepare to celebrate the third Sunday of Lent. In Colombia, Development and Peace's partner, the Antioquia Peasants Association, works with young people from peasant communities who have endured over 50 years of war and violence. To foster a culture of peace, they provide multimedia training to young people, helping them promote their culture and biodiversity. One of the trainees, a young man named Fabio, said, "The training encouraged us to stay in our community and to identify with it. It was a great experience because we developed a sense of belonging by telling our story and acting for the good of our community. This is why we continue and stay here." Our celebrant today is Father Rico. Please stand and join in our processional hymn.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
As we gather and begin our third week of Lent, we ask the Lord's mercy at this Mass as we pray in a special way for the repose of the souls of Ludmilla Hilbert, Ricky Resigen, and Peter Riley. For the times we fail to follow God's commandments, as we hear in our first reading, we bow our heads and ask for God's mercy, for he is slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at God's right hand. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, author of every mercy and of all goodness, who in prayer, fasting, and almsgiving have shown us a remedy for sin, look graciously on this confession of our lowliness, that we who are bowed down by our conscience may always be lifted up by your mercy. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Exodus. God spoke all these words, "I am the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery. You shall have no other gods before me. You shall not make for yourself an idol, whether in the form of anything that is in heaven above, or that is on the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. You shall not bow down to them or worship them, for I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God, punishing children for the iniquity of parents, to the third and fourth generation of those who reject me, but showing steadfast love to the thousandth generation of those who love me and keep my commandments. You shall not make wrongful use of the name of the Lord your God, for the Lord will not acquit anyone who misuses his name. Remember the Sabbath day and keep it holy. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work, but the seventh day is a Sabbath to the Lord your God. You shall not do any work, you, your son or your daughter, your male or female slave, your livestock, or the alien resident in your towns. For in the 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth, the sea, and all that is in them, but rested the seventh day. Therefore the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and consecrated it. Honor your father and your mother, so that your days may be long in the land, and the Lord your God is giving you. You shall not murder. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not bear false witness against your neighbor. You shall not covet your neighbor's house. You shall not covet your neighbor's wife, or male or female slave, or ox or donkey, or anything that belongs to your neighbor. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Heavens declare the glory of God. The skies proclaim the work of his hands. Day after day they pour forth their speech. Night after night they teach. There is no place, nowhere on earth, where their voice cannot be heard. Their words go out through all the earth to the end of the world, and in them God has placed the sun rising from his grand pavilion, like a groom coming out of his chamber to see his bride. Like a strong man runs his race with joy, it laughs and bounds his way across the sky. There is nothing hidden from its warmth and the perfect love of God. The love of the Lord is perfect, renewing and reviving the soul. The testimonies of the Lord are sure, making the foolish wise. The precepts of the Lord are right, delighting and rejoicing the heart. The commandment of the Lord is pure, enlightening the eyes. And the fear of the Lord is clean, it endures forever. And the judgments of the Lord are true and always right. His word is more to be desired than all the finest gold in the world, sweeter than the honeycomb. In his word is warning and great reward. His word is more to be desired than all the finest gold in the world, sweeter than the honeycomb. In his word is warning and great reward.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the message about the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, But to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. For Jews demand signs and Greeks desire wisdom, but we proclaim Christ crucified, a stumbling block to Jews and foolishness to Gentiles. But to those who are the called, both Jews and Greeks, Christ the power of God and the wisdom of God. For God's foolishness is wiser than human wisdom, and God's weakness is stronger than human strength. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that everyone who believes in him may have eternal life. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
My brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. The Passover of the Jews was near, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. In the temple he found people selling cattle, sheep, and doves, and the money changers seated at their tables, making a whip of cords. He drove them all out of the temple, both the sheep and the cattle. He also poured out the coins of the money changers and overturned their tables. He told those who were selling the doves, "Take these out of here. Stop making my Father's house a marketplace." His disciples remembered that it was written, "Zeal for your house will consume me." The Jews then said to him, "What sign can you show us for doing this?" Jesus answered them, "Destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up." They then said, "This temple has been under construction for 46 years, and you will raise it up in 3 days?" But Jesus was speaking of the temple of his body. After he was raised from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this, and they believed the scripture and the word that Jesus had spoken. When he was in Jerusalem during the Passover festival, many believed in his name because they saw the signs that he was doing. But Jesus, on his part, would not entrust himself to them because he knew all people and needed no one to testify about human nature, for he himself knew what was in the human person. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
Friends, this third week of Lent draws us into an appreciation for two things: the commandments of God and respect for his house. The commandments of God and respect for his house. When we enter this place of worship, as you enter those holy doors, do you respect this place differently than any other place? Or is it business as usual? This is not the coffee shop. This is not the Peach King Arena. This is a house of prayer. Therefore, it must be respected as such, as Jesus reminds the people of his time. They were so caught up in doing business and catching up with each other. He says, "Stop making my Father's house a marketplace." What would Jesus say about our hearts as we gather today? And those of you who are gathered at home? Because as soon as we enter into Mass,
the world ends. John Paul II said that no priest should ever celebrate Mass with a watch on because it doesn't matter what time it is. What matters is we have entered into this holy time of prayer, an encounter with God in which we should be so profoundly blessed to be in his presence. So notice that for 6 years as your pastor, I very, very, very rarely greet you in the foyer of the church before Mass. If you find me in the foyer, it's because the end of the last Mass is coming out or something needs to be looked after. It's not about, hey, Father Rico, disappointed that the Canucks won last night. I know your Leafs lost. Hey, I haven't seen you in a long time. That's after Mass. As we enter into these holy doors, we are reminded that this is an encounter with the risen Lord. And that you and I should have hearts that are desiring to encounter him on a very unique, beautiful, and individual basis. And God bless you, you're here. Fantastic. But if we just show up, is this just a duty? Jesus wants our heart. We hear of the Father who is a jealous God in the first reading, who deserves the worship that is his due. Every breath you and I take is a gift from God. And so as we enter in, friends, how did you even enter the pew? Did you give reverence to Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament? Father Rico, I can't genuflect. My body doesn't allow me. Did you bow your head? You see, it starts with the mindset. As soon as I enter into these holy doors, this place is different. This ground is holy. Not because of me, obviously. And not because of you, my brothers and sisters. But because God is here. But Father Rico, God is everywhere. Absolutely he is. Absolutely he is. But the scriptures remind us that his presence in his holy temple, his presence right here, sacramentally in the tabernacle, is as close as we're ever going to get to heaven while still on earth. Pay attention to the closing prayer at Mass today. It's very profound. That as we stay here on earth, this encounter with God, it's just a little foretaste of heaven until that day when God will call us home to be with him. Friends, what a beautiful reminder for all of us. Jesus was not having a bad day. When Father Rico, Father Bill, and Father Ed remind us to be quiet as we enter church, we're not having a bad day. It's a reminder that we are to be reverent, that we are to be respectful, and that we are to give that time that God wants with us because he is so in love with you. In the first reading, we also hear of what is near and dear to God's heart, and that's the following of his commandments. Throughout the Metanoia series, the first three videos have helped us to really focus on what is important to God. Father David, the Franciscan, reminds us that the commandments are not old school. What must I do to inherit eternal life, the rich young man says. Jesus says, follow the commandments and sell what you have and follow me. In other words, follow these 10 commandments of God and then have no attachment which separates yourself from me. That's Jesus' response. So how are we doing with the Ten Commandments? This was one of the most important discussion questions I left us with. What are the commandments that I am struggling with right now? This Lent, 2021. What are the commandments that I struggle with? Where are my sins? Where are my weaknesses? Where do I need God's grace to permeate my very soul? These are the areas in which Jesus is telling me to move from here to where I need to be a saint. And a good coach and a good teacher never lets his or her players or students stay right where they are. Rather, they encourage them, they influence them, they support them, they guide them, they teach them to get where they need to be. And this is how the Father talks to us in the book of Exodus. These are the commandments to live by. Because if I don't guide you, it's easy to fall off track, right? If you and I didn't have parents to remind us the straight and narrow, how would we ever know right from wrong? It's not a parent's job to be their friend of the child, although unfortunately, it's very evident in many cases where parents try that. This is not our job as parents. Your job is to get your children to heaven. My job is to get you to heaven. I need to teach you the truth. Otherwise, I don't get there. And respectfully, friends, I want heaven desperately. And I know you do too. That's why we're here. But these commandments are often remembered here. But how frequently do we actually abide by them is the question. My parents' favorite commandment, the fourth one, honor your mother and father. Father David, in his last video, talks about backpack envy in his pilgrimage on the Camino. That deals with commandments 9 and 10. Are we jealous and envious of others? Do we want their lives? Does it look like the grass is greener on their side of the fence? Instead of realizing the blessings that God has given to me and how he wants me to grow in relationship with him. And when crosses come, to turn to him for my strength. I don't carry it alone. In fact, I even think I'm carrying the cross. Jesus is carrying my cross. I'm the Simon. I'm at the back. Jesus is driving my bus, and he's driving yours too. What are the commandments of God that you're struggling with, friends? What are you and I actively doing in our struggle with those commandments? That's what Lent is. Metanoia is about conversion. It's about transformation. It's not about business as usual. Jesus is not interested in business as usual. Just do your best, and everyone will get to heaven. Find me where that is in the scriptures, and I'll give you $1 million. Because it's not there. It's not there. Jesus is pushing us to holiness. He calls himself the way, the truth, and the life. The Father reveals to us, like in last week's gospel, this is my beloved Son. Listen to him. So if Jesus is flipping tables, then obviously we're not doing our job. If the Father needs to remind us of the commandments of God, then obviously we're not doing our job. If he gives us the sacrament of healing, especially that of reconciliation, and we're not going, we're not doing our job. But thank God that he is slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love. Thank God that he gives us this holy season of Lent to be transformed, to look in the mirror, to ask ourselves those questions. Lord, help me to grow in holiness. Lord, help me to be like you. So friends, if you haven't already started, ask yourself the question, am I holier today than I was on Ash Wednesday? Am I holier today than I was last Lent? And if the answer is no or we're unsure, this is the time. This is the opportunity of grace. Lord, thank you for being patient with me as I continue to wrestle with my own demons. Lord, thank you for allowing me this time to stop complaining about the rest of the world and start working on me. Rico needs to work on Rico. You need to work on you. Because the only way we get to heaven is by making daily decisions. As Father David reminded us in video 3 of the words of Jesus, if you wish to be my disciple, you must deny yourself, take up your cross, and follow me. When's the last time you and I did any of those things? And this is not a guilt homily. This is an encouragement homily. This is a great push by God, the God of mercy, that lifts us up. But he will not settle for mediocre disciples. Jesus says in the scriptures he wishes us to be hot or cold. When we are lukewarm, he wishes to spit us out of his mouth. Thank you, Lord, for waking us up. Thank you, Lord, for the opportunity of grace. Thank you, Lord, for these beautiful scriptures that call us to love of you. So, friends, in a few weeks, in addition to every Saturday, or whenever you need to go to reconciliation, Father Bill and I are welcome to hear your confession. We are, with joy, instruments of God's mercy, just as I frequent the sacrament at least every 2 weeks. This is the time to offer to God, Lord, I am a hot mess in these areas, and yet you love me. Thank you for your patience. But Lord, instead of picking on all the issues of everyone else in the world, government rules that I don't like, lines that are too long, things that I miss, can't do this, can't do that, let's focus right here. You focus right there so that we can grow in holiness. So that this encounter at this Mass, when we leave the doors, is transformative. We speak as Jesus does, and we do as he tells us. Why? First, out of duty, until we actually come to an understanding of deep desire. Lord, by my life, I wish to please you. Lord, by my witness, I wish to lead others to you. Lord, at the end of my life, I wish to be with you forever in heaven. May this Lenten journey be different, my brothers and sisters, as we move into this fourth video today, in which Father David and the Franciscans help us to move into what's called sin and mercy. You thought the first three videos were good. Wait till see what the Holy Spirit has in store for us this week. Lord, help us to be like you.
As we humbly stand before our God, let us proudly profess our faith in him using the words of the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sin. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. My brothers and sisters, God understands human nature very well. He knows our needs, he knows our limitations, and he knows our sins. Confidently, we turn to the God of mercy and place our needs into his hands of this loving and generous God.
The response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may always be a living sign of God's love and mercy in times of darkness and despair. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May people of all nations heed the commandments of God written into our hearts and bring the world to peace and reconciliation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For protectors of the earth around the world who care for species and preserve the biodiversity of the earth, our common home, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In this year of celebrating the 175th anniversary of our Cathedral Church, for those who have turned to God for forgiveness in the Sacrament of Reconciliation at our cathedral and throughout our diocese, that they may be assured of God's forgiveness, love, and mercy. As a diocesan family, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and all those who are suffering may realize from the care and attention shown them that they are loved by God, especially Tony Petrovich, Francis and Jenny Bozo, Matteo DiFoco, Mary Cardoni, and Michelle Robertson. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We remember our beloved dead, especially Peter Riley, Julian Vachon, Simone Massac, Brian Fraser, Ron Vuca, Michael McKean, Frank Aiello, Stephen Bach, Vivian Kriz-Oski, Carmen Castiglione, Harmon Grotelars, and Walter Gretzky. May they all share in the glory of the resurrection. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also pray for Ludmila Hilbert and Ricky Rezigen. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all the intentions we verbalize to God from the silence of our hearts. Loving and merciful Father, you offer us a covenant in which we have become your living temple. Hear these our prayers and help us to persevere in our Lenten penance. We ask these in all things through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I have climbed highest mountain, I have run through the fields, only to be with you, only to be with you. I have run, I have crawled, I've scaled these city walls, only to be with you. I still haven't found what I'm looking for, but I still haven't found what I'm looking for. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord, open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you, I want to see you. Eyes of my heart, Lord, open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you, I want to see you. See you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing holy, holy, holy. Holy, 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 I want to see you. I believe in the kingdom come, and all the colors bleed into one, bleed into one. But yes, I'm still running. You broke the bond, loose the chains, carried the cross of my shame,
of my shame. You know I believe it, but I still haven't found what I'm looking for. But I still haven't found what I'm looking for. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. See you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing, holy, 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 holy. I want to see you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this bread which we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
By the mingling of this water and wine, we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine which we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord. May our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, of my iniquity. Cleanse me of my many sins. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Amen. Be pleased, O Lord, with these sacrificial offerings, and grant that we who beseech pardon for our own sins may take care to forgive our neighbor, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have given your children a sacred time for the renewing and purifying of their hearts, that freed from disordered affections, they may so deal with the things of this passing world as to hold rather to the things that eternally endure. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim. This Mass, we use Eucharistic prayer for reconciliation number one. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and from the world's beginning are ceaselessly at work, so that the human race may become holy just as you yourself are holy. Look, we pray upon your people's offerings and pour out on them the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, in whom we too are your sons and daughters. Indeed, though we once were lost and could not approach you, you loved us with the greatest love, for your Son, who alone is just, handed himself over to death and did not disdain to be nailed for our sake to the wood of the cross. But before his arms were outstretched between heaven and earth to become the lasting sign of your covenant, he desired to celebrate the Passover with his disciples. As he ate with them, he took bread and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to them, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." My Lord and my God. In a similar way, when supper was ended, knowing that he was about to reconcile all things in himself through his blood to be shed on the cross, he took the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, and once more giving you thanks, handed the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." My Jesus, mercy. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is our Passover and our surest peace, we celebrate his death and resurrection from the dead, and looking forward to his blessed coming, we offer you, who are our faithful and merciful God, this sacrificial victim who reconciles to you the entire human race. Look kindly, most compassionate Father, on those you unite to yourself by the sacrifice of your Son, and grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, as they partake of this one bread and one chalice, may they be gathered into one body in Christ who heals every division. Be pleased to keep us always in communion of mind and heart. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Gerard, our Bishop, help us to work together for the coming of your kingdom until the hour when we stand before you, saints among the saints in the halls of heaven, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her husband, with your blessed apostles, with Saint Catherine of Alexandria, and with all the saints, and with our deceased brothers and sisters, whom we humbly commend to your mercy. Then, freed at last from the wound of corruption, and made fully into a new creation, we shall sing to you with gladness the thanksgiving of Christ who lives for all eternity. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, the peace of the Lord be always with you. Turn and offer one another a sign of the Lord's peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin.
Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, who by the will of the Father and work of the Holy Spirit, through your death gave life to the world, free us by this your most holy body and blood from all our sins and from all that is evil. Keep us faithful to your commandments, and never let us be parted from you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring us all to everlasting life. Amen. May the blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life. Amen. For those at home who have received Jesus in a spiritual communion, I invite you to pray. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. For those here in the church, a reminder of how to go to communion at this time. Please keep the mask in front of your face, especially when you stand in front of me. Wait till after I've said the body of Christ, after you've said amen. Not before, after you've said amen. Then kindly remove your mask to protect my safety too, please. You'll receive Jesus reverently on your hand. Place him in your mouth, and then place the mask back over your face. Thank you. Please wait until the usher escorts you forward.
drowning in my questions and found a God who holds all wisdom. I trusted you, I stepped out on the ocean. You calmed my hand among the waves. You're the God of all my days. Each step I take, God of all my days. I ran from you, wandered in the shadows, and found a God who relentlessly pursues. I hid from you, haunted by my failure. On you when I was at my weakest, and found a God, the lifter of my head. I worship you and felt you right beside me. You're the reason that I sing, 'cause you're the God of all my days. Each step I take, you make away. I will give you all my praise. My seasons change, you stay the same. You're the God of all my days. In my worry, God, you are my stillness. In my search, God, you are my answer. In my blindness, God, you are my vision. In my bondage, God, you are my freedom. In my weakness, God, you are my power. You're the reason that I sing, 'cause you're the God of all my days. I take, you make a way. I will give you all my praise. My seasons change, you stay the same. You're the God of all my days. In my blindness, God, you are my vision. In my bondage, God, you are my freedom all my days. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. I can feel His mighty power and His grace. I can hear the brush of angels' wings, see glory on each face. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. In the midst of His children, two or three, and I feel that same sweet spirit that I felt oft times before. Surely I can say I've been with the Lord. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. I can feel His mighty power and His grace. I can hear the brush of angels' wings, see glory on each face. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. There's a holy hush around us as the glory fills this place. I've touched the hem of His garment. I can almost see His face, and my heart is overflowing with the fullness of His joy. Of angels' wings, see glory on each face. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this
Let us pray. As we receive the pledge of things yet hidden in heaven and are nourished while still on earth with the bread that comes from on high, we humbly entreat you, O Lord, that what is being brought about in us in mystery may come to true completion through Christ our Lord. Let us turn to our Blessed Mother as we pray. We fly to thy protection, O Holy Mother of God. Despise not our petitions and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin, amen. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in the day of battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. Unto thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl through the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Before the solemn blessing, a few announcements. Friends here in the church, a gentle reminder, you must still sign up. Contact tracing is still a rule. So everyone has to sign up online. For those of you who don't have computers and internet, that's what the binder is in the foyer. For those who have computers and internet, the binder is not for you, okay? Please still sign up online. It's easier for me to trace everything because the workload is immense, okay? The fines start at $2,000. Start at $2,000. We want our church open at 30% and higher. Please participate with me. I'm begging you, and I thank you. So for those who don't have computers, every time you come to church, you have to sign that binder. Every single time. Until I tell you no more, okay? Which would be nice to be today, but it's not. So please sign up online and please sign the binder. Capito means do you understand? Everyone nod. Fantastic. Because I know when you don't, because I know who you are, right? This is not a threat. You have to work with me, friends, okay? Please. And I thank those of you who are. Those who aren't, yes, I'm in the business of forgiveness. But you need to do it. Thank you. Number two, in my email, 20 updates in our parish. We've got our Knights of Columbus bottle drive coming up, our development and peace campaign, which reminds us of those who are most in need, the many online resources we continue to have. I want you to continue to pray for those who are preparing for the sacraments. We have Reconciliation Part 2 for our little friends in grade 2 tomorrow and the last group next week. We have those in our CIA who long for the sacraments. We need to be praying for each other, friends. This is the most important thing we do, worship of God and praying for one another. And I know you are doing that, so continue to do just that. And then finally, on behalf of Father Bill and I welcome you to the safest place on earth. With masks, with sanitizing, with the distancing, all those at home, it's time to come back to receive Jesus in Holy Communion. Those here in the church, tell all your family and friends it's time to come back. I've been saying this for now 12 months. It's your job to help me to bring everyone to the altar of God so that God can bless us with the grace of a sacramental communion. My brothers and sisters, bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Direct, O Lord, we pray, the hearts of your faithful, and in your kindness, grant your servants this grace, that abiding in the love of you and of their neighbor, they may fulfill the whole of your commands, through Christ our Lord. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. The Mass has ended. Our Lenten journey continues. Let us go forth in the peace and love of Jesus Christ.
Above all things, his love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise. With a mighty hand and outstretched arm, his love endures forever. For the life that's been reborn, setting sun.
His love endures forever.
And by the grace of God, we will carry on.
His love endures forever.
Sing praise. Sing praise. Sing praise. Sing praise. Forever God is faithful. Forever God. Forever God.